Hi friend, it's Ron from CamMastery.com, where you can go to learn how to make great videos with Camtasia. This is a free lesson Friday, which means you get a free lesson right from my Camtasia Mastery course. If you want to get the entire course, you can head over to CamMastery.com/store and pick up that course. Now, onto the video. The first thing we want to do is synchronize our audio from our camera to the audio that we've recorded externally. So for me, that's on my lapel mic that I recorded directly into my smartphone. Now I've downloaded that to my computer, and I also have the screen recording. So all three of these, a screen recording, a camera file, and my audio are here in my media bin. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag each of these down to the tracks. So I'm gonna grab the voice first because, you know, I like to have my audio as the lowest track. And then I'll grab my screen recording next, and I will put my smiling face up on top. Okay, so now I've aligned each of these, and I'll just grab these and drag them off to the left so they're all aligned at the left. But you can see that for the audio, none of these are aligned. So this is the same recording around the same time, but none of these are in sync. And I'll click this magnifying glass so you can see the whole recording. Now to synchronize these, I think it's fairly easy to get these items synchronized so that they're all happening at precisely the same time. One of the things you can do during a recording is have a clap, and that'll give you a spike. But you can see throughout here, it's fairly easy to see where things are aligned and where they aren't. So for example, I do see a little spike here, here, and here. I know that those are all going to line up. So what I'll do is I'll deselect all of these, and I'll start to align these based on this, whatever this noise is right here. I don't know what it is, maybe I'm coughing or sneezing or dropping something, who knows? Looks like I'm fumbling with papers. So what I do is I zoomed out, so I use the magnifying glass to zoom out to see the whole project. And then this gives me a good idea. I can look at where these gaps are and say, okay, well here's a big gap here, that aligns with this big gap here, or if you wanna look at the spikes and say, okay, well here's where the spikes are, that's where I'll start. And then I'll just jump in a little bit on the timeline and say, okay, well, let's get a little more granular. Let's say this is off to the right. Let's move this a little further to the right. And let's move this a little further to the right. So now I'm looking here and I see there are really like two spikes that I have that I've aligned here. Now let me zoom in a little further. Okay, those are fairly close. I don't know, might move this over just a bit, maybe this one over a bit. And now let me zoom in all the way. And I'll drag just a little bit this way to find those spikes. All right, and now what I use is I'll use the playhead, the line, this vertical line, to properly align these as best I can. So I'm putting this right here. It looks like it's at the tip of this, and maybe this goes over one more. That's about right. So these bottom two seem to be lined up. But this one, you can see, I can't get it exactly aligned. I'm a little bit ahead or a little bit behind on the audio. Now, I know that this is my camera recording, so my preference for a camera is to be just a little bit ahead. And the reason for that is that it takes just a fraction of a second for the sound to leave my mouth and to get to the camera. So, like I said, when in doubt, I'll move this just a tiny bit ahead when needed. Now, when I back out, I can see everything looks to be perfectly aligned. Now that I have everything aligned, what I'll do is I'll save this project. Now let me give you a trick that has helped me whenever I've gotten things out of alignment. We'll talk about resynchronizing audio here in a little bit. But once I have all three of these aligned, what I'll do is I'll find the shortest one and I will align the end times to match on all three. I'll do the same thing at the beginning. I'll grab these and make sure all three of the beginnings are aligned. And the reason for this is if something were to get out of sync, I can just click and drag and then it snaps back to the place that I need. So that's been a tip that has saved me a lot of time. Once you have all the files synchronized, go ahead and trim the front and end to make sure everything's aligned. I want to show you another option that I used to use and I no longer recommend. If you look at my video file, we know that it's video and audio both. What I used to do is I used to right click and I used to separate audio and video. And so what it would do is it would create the audio track by itself and the video track by itself. And the reason I would do that is I would say, well, I have this great audio down here from my microphone. I don't need any of the camera audio ever. So I would just click that track and I would delete it and I would never need it again. Well, sometimes things would get out of sync and then I couldn't find that audio. I can't go back and get that audio back into this video track. So if you wanted to, you could do that. But again, I recommend against separating the audio and video for that reason. It might be that things get out of sync and you need that as a guide later on. Instead, what I now do is I'll select the track that no longer needs the audio, and then I'll go up to the properties to the audio tab, and I'll change the gain down to 0, and that wipes it out. I'll do the same thing for my screen recording. I used the external mic. It was too loud. You can see it went all the way to the top. That was awful. I'll never use that audio, but it doesn't matter because I'm going to drag it all the way down. So that way I make both of those audio tracks nothing, and all I have is the audio from my external microphone. Now, one of the things that I like to do is to test a sample of this. So what we can do is we can highlight a section of this video, and then what I would do is right click and produce timeline selection as. Now, we're going to talk about production in module 6, but for now, you can see you can do this produce timeline selection as, and then you can choose something simple like this MP4 only, say next, and then save it in this folder, and then play that to make sure that what you have is going to look and sound right for you. So that helps you to test just to make sure that everything is perfectly in sync.